There's one I like very much called the oyster, where you separate out and go like this and then just sink underneath water and then pop up and spin around and go underwater. Yeah, I point my toes well. When I first started, and there were a lot more of us, we were meeting every day. You know, just because of the love of swimming and just fooling around and trying out new stunts and inventing new stunts and just having a ball. So to have aquadettes and to have other people to swim with and to synchronize with and try to perfect something as best we could. And I was the youngest for a couple of years, so that was good. And geez, it was fun. Well, it was early July, and I was having some episodes, particularly at the end of the day, of vomiting. I just, all of a sudden, nausea would hit me. I knew every bathroom within a mile, you know. Frankly, I was overwhelmed at both ends. I can't live that way. You can't do anything. It was awful to be out of control. I mean, all the other symptoms that sneak up with MS, I'd never had anything overwhelm me. That was the first time as long as I've had MS. But that's when I got started on the medical marijuana, and it was the difference between staying alive versus, you know, versus killing myself, because I was certainly ready to do that too. I don't think of myself as an old person. I don't think of myself really as a senior. I don't know when senior age starts. I have a husband to take care of that I don't want my children to have to take care of. And so control is really an important part of my life. When you have MS, you have to either resign yourself to it or else you have to not fight it, but find ways to live with it because it's so chronic. I knew nothing about it. Look, I'm a nurse. I've worked on detox units, et cetera, et cetera. But I knew nothing about marijuana. I could feel the wave coming, and I moved fast. And I had it ready, and I took a couple of puffs, lit it and had a couple of puffs, and all I did was hold it in my mouth like this. As long as I could. And then I blew it out. I didn't even inhale it. I just blew it out and waited. And sure enough, I was so busy deciding whether or not I was high, I completely realized I wasn't nauseated. And that was it. To think that I had some way that I could control some of the symptoms. And that made an enormous difference. I mean, to have no control, and I don't have a lot of control over the increasing the disease, but to have any control, since I'm a basically, you know, Margot Control Bauer. It's my middle name. So it's helped me live. It's as simple as that.
I've been all around this great big world, and I've seen all kinds of girls. Yeah, but I couldn't wait to get back in the States, back to the cutest girls in the world. I wish they all could be California. I wish they all could be California. I wish they all could be California.
You know, those people are getting older. And then I look at me, you know. This year is the first year I've been aware of my disease in the water, because usually I swim everything. And once in the water, I have no issue of stamina or anything else. So, and I would practice 2, 3, 4 times a week. I have a feeling a lot of us, and I'm speaking of all of us, sit around and almost chalk off on the calendar how many days I've yet to live without knowing for sure. Because it's hard to know what the next goal should be other than staying alive. And so many people here just go to the doctors. The big structure in their life is to go to the doctor. How many pills? Go to the doctor, that sort of thing. That stinks. You see, that's no quality of life. But the point is, they're still alive, but I don't call it quality. To me, quality is independence. That's what I'm losing so much of. I've got to remember how I used to feel. I mean, I got to remember what used to make me enthusiastic. I'd go down and go right now surfing if I had someone who could help me get back out. I got to remember I want to do those things, that I want to do those things. Because if you come to a point where you don't want to do any of these things, then where is life?